Yeah. Hi everyone, welcome back to our, I don't know how many podcasts already?
No, this is our first podcast.
Okay, so today's date is 1st November and we are in the middle of a food park.
Basically, we're in the middle of Bedok Corner, which is like the best place for our first podcast.
Very best.
Yes.
Okay, so the purpose of this podcast, have you thought about it?
No, we have not thought about the purpose of our podcast. We just thought about, you know, this morning I woke up, I was like, hey, let's do a podcast.
Yes, in the middle of a food center.
Yes.
Okay, and our tummies are really, really full now from the good food here.
Yep.
So basically today, of course, after you have a full tummy, what do you think about? You think about sleeping.
Sleep, man.
Right. But today, we are not going to talk about how to sleep well. We just going to talk about basically sleeping, the problems that we face, and what are the sleeping disorders, or what can it, how can it affect you, right, Asha?
Yes.
And we have to put a disclaimer here. It is not, whatever we say, it is not, how to say, prescriptive for anything.
Yeah. It is basically our opinion, it's not an advice because we're not sleep experts or experts.
Yeah.
You know?
Correct. So maybe we can start with Aisha. So Aisha wanna share about her sleep pattern.
So I was asleep, of course, it's night. And I woke up thinking that I don't have enough sleep. And this is basically because I have late nights at work, so I have like very irregular sleep patterns since I was young. But I read that you should have 8 hours of sleep, or maybe from some other people like lesser sleep, but you should have very good deep sleep because it helps to restore your memory and, you know, help you be more alert during the day.
Which, right.
Yeah, I was actually panicking because I don't know it's because if I use my phone a lot or what, but my memory it's not as good as it was before.
Also because you're older, hello.
Hey, not that.
Okay, so talking about deep sleep, it's very interesting. I chanced upon a post on Instagram, or was it a website? I can't remember. That deep sleep, you don't even need to achieve it. No, sorry. You, it's not, you own. Okay, let me rephrase myself. You don't just achieve deep sleep only when you sleep 8 hours or 6 hours. The so-called
true
prescribed, universally. Yeah. But there are certain timing, for example, if they say you sleep for 10 minutes, it's actually called a power nap, and it's you actually going to a deep sleep. So when you come, when you wake up, you actually feel refreshed. But when you go further from 10, longer than 10 minutes, for example, half an hour, when you wake up, you feel very sluggish. And then again, there are certain intervals. So it's quite interesting, I chanced upon that post. So the deep sleep doesn't mean you have to spend 8 hours sleeping. There are some, I think it's something to do with neurology, you know.
So basically, right, about your power nap stuff, I also read that 20 minutes of power nap every day is actually good, again, for your memory. So, yeah, these people who take
lunch breaks, sleep.
Yeah, just 20 minutes, but don't go over 20 minutes. Between 15 to 20 minutes is the best timing. So, you know, I don't know what, but I read something like it helps your brain neurons, brain to regenerate cells and all that.
And it's not even just for young children, it's for adults.
Yeah, for adults actually.
Okay, so now, if you have any questions or any comments, you can DM us at Nargis Official.
Whatever we can answer, we answer. Yeah. But again, disclaimer, we are not experts.
Yes.
It's basically based on what we read.
Yep.
And, I don't know, I was looking at this food. I can't even look at food anymore.
Feel hungry. Okay, so the next part of it is what this topic that I want to bring on the table. Okay, it's about sleep paralysis. Okay, why I want to...
Anyway, it's Halloween today.
Yes, 31st October.
Oh, yesterday, sorry.
Yes. But we didn't say Halloween. Okay, now
have
back
you had sleep paralysis before?
Yes, that's what I want to talk about.
Oh my god, I had one too. It was scary.
Okay. So I initially, okay, this happened not just once or twice, many times, and it happens when I'm about to fall asleep. That means you're consciously aware that you're about to fall asleep, okay? And how, oh no, my battery is dying. How you realize is that your mind is like, they say your body is already going to fall asleep. That means your brain is not shutting down lah, like your muscles are relaxing, okay?
Oh, yeah.
But your mind is still active. So that's when the sleep paralysis occurs, okay? And you find yourself like in a trance, like you want to say something. Have you ever felt like I'm sure you have.
Oh my god, I felt like I want to move my hand, but I can't move my hand.
And you get so freaked out, you know, and then, you know, us Muslims, we start to say all the prayers.
Yeah, I thought I got hantu duduk, alright.
Sometimes I thought I got paralyzed.
You know, when I had to say prayers, I actually forgot. I forgot, even Al-Fatiha, I forgot.
And you start cursing yourself.
Right? Yeah.
So this sleep paralysis is very legit. Research for that, which I'm going to look up.
It's basically normal. Yeah. Like, just don't have to worry about it. Yeah. Unless it happens frequently to you.
Right. And usually you shake yourself out of it, lah. Right?
Yeah, I can't remember how I got out of it.
And then you start to get very scared and all that. So let me get the okay, that means all this we have to already.
There was once I was like in this half asleep state.
Yeah.
I thought somebody pulled my blanket. But it was actually my knee jerk. No.
Oh, Aisha.
No, it's like
why is it not shocking to me, all these stupid things happening to me? Okay, so I got the definition on Google So it says that sleep paralysis is a temporary inability to move or speak that occurs when you're waking up or falling asleep.
Waking up, like you don't hear much, yeah?
Yeah,
usually falling asleep.
Yeah.
Because I don't know.
It's not harmful and should pass in a few seconds or minutes, but can be very frightening.
I think it was minutes, yeah. But I still don't remember how I get out of it.
Okay, so one question is, how can I avoid sleep paralysis? Okay, it says, if you have occasional sleep paralysis, you can take steps at home to control the disorder. Oh, it's a disorder, Aisha.
Probably if you have a lot.
Start by making sure you get enough sleep, alright? Do what you can to relieve stress in your life. Especially just before bedtime. Try new sleeping positions if you sleep on your back. How would you know?
I never sleep on my back. I always sleep on my side. I know it's the same.
Okay. And so funny, just below it. What is the name of the demon that sits on your chest? What?
What?
Okay. In Pashtun culture, isn't it Pakistani? Iranian. Yeah, Iranian, is it? Oh, Iranian. In Pashtun culture, it is known as Kapasa. It is believed that it is a ghost without thumb fingers.
Wow. Tak ada thumb masa dia duduk atau
orang. Yes, all the other four. The ghost tries to suffocate you by pressing your throat and sitting on your chest. Okay.
Okay, thanks. After you explain that it's not a ghost, then you talk about this kapasa.
Google, why kapasa? You do this kind of question? Kapasa. Kau kapasa seh.
Very fake eh.
Yeah, so I think we can go on and on about sleeping. You know, if you have any sleeping disorders that you have encountered, you know, or something that has been burdening you all your life, right? Do share it with us. You know, we can ask around.
Apa yang you nak share? DM.
Yeah, DM.
Cakap share. Let's just
Yeah. So please do, so that we can surface it, do some research, you know, just something fun, get it off your mind and all that. Do DM us.
But just see a doctor lah. Ini bukan Dr. Nabila.
Yeah lah, of course lah, masih the doctor lah, okay?
See the doctor.
So, okay, we hope that we have brought some light into your life.
Yes.
About sleeping.
Please forgive us, this is our very first podcast. Yes. It's very raw.
Yes.
Raw.
Oh, yes.
Oh my god.
This is a sneak peek.
Our new t-shirt collection, guys. Hopefully, just wait for it.
Oh my god, you guys will love it. Okay, so we will sign off from here. We'll see you. You'll hear from us soon.
Yeah. See you.
Bye.